So we have the theories of interest, and under this the first theory is classical theory of interest. The classical theory of rate of interest has been defined by the classical economists like Ricardo, Mill, Marshall, Pigou. Altogether, they have developed a classical theory of interest which has been given various names. The other names of these theories are capital theory of interest, the saving investment theory of interest, or the real theory of interest. So, the classical economists defined this theory as a phenomenon like which defines interest as a real phenomena. So, interest is always determined by real factors, and that is exclusively. So, we can say that according to the classical theory of interest, the rate of interest is determined as an exclusively real factor, and it is done under the demand and supply for capital under the perfect competition scenario. This theory has been defined under certain assumptions. So such assumptions are: there must prevail perfect competition in the market, there must also be full employment of resources, the economic agents must be rational person, he should not be a miser or a lunatic, the level of price is supposed to be constant, and money is also supposed to be neutral. After the assumption, we are in a position to define the theory. So this theory has been defined on the basis of demand for capital and supply for capital. According to the classical economists, the demand for capital and the supply for capital brings out the mean rate of interest, and this theory is based upon the interaction of demand and supply for capital. So the supply for capital basically depends upon savings, which in turn depends upon the basic psychological, economic and institutional factors, which are the willingness to save, the power to save, and also the facilities available for saving. So saving is a social virtue. What is saving actually? Saving means curtailment of consumption or postponement of present consumption. So basically, when we save, what we do is we practice abstinence. We practice abstinence for and part with our current purchasing power. Thus, savings requires a particular amount of savings and abstinence, and also requires waiting, because when we save, we get our money after a particular period of time with a certain rate of interest, which is considered to be the reward for the abstinence we are taking or the sacrifice or waiting we are taking. Thus, savings can be regarded as an inducement for the act of saving or foregoing the present consumption. Next, we have the demand for capital. Why is capital demanded? Capital is basically demanded because capital is productive and it helps in bringing us profits. So basically the investors demand capital, and the demand for capital depends on one hand on the productivity of capital, and on the other hand on the rate of interest. So these are the two factors which influence the demand for capital. The demand for capital firstly depends upon the rate of productivity. That means if we are investing on that capital, how much we are getting back in return. Also, the cost of capital is the cost of investment, that is the rate of interest, is how much extra money we have to pay for taking up the demand for the capital. Thus, at higher rate of interest, if the rate of interest is high, the producers demand less capital, and at lower capital rate of interest, they demand low capital. Thus, these are the factors for which capitals are demanded. So, after defining the demand for and supply for capital, we are in a position to explain the theory in the form of a figure. So, if you see in the figure, we can see that the DD curve is the demand curve and SS curve is the supply curve. Both of them are intersecting at point E. So the equilibrium rate of interest is OI, whereas the OM is the quantity of capital demanded at supplied at this rate. In other words, we can see that at the point of equilibrium E, we are finding the equilibrium rate of interest OI is equal to the savings is equal to OM. So any deviation from this equilibrium rate of interest will be unstable. So as the classical theory defines, the rate of interest is found out by the interaction of the demand and the supply curve. Even if there is any kind of deviation, that deviation is just temporary or unstable, and it will move back to the position of E.